Hello, I'm Dr. Soumya Basanth, working as a cornea consultant at Zamindar's Microsurgical Eye Center for the past 5 years. Dry eye seems to affect a sizable number of population. Why do you think there's a huge increase in the dry eye symptomatology in the population? It is because of our modern day lifestyle, use of ACs, humidifiers, contact lens wear, computer usage. All these have a causative effect on the dry eye. Dry eye usually occurs if there's an insufficiency of tear production or excessive evaporation of the existing tears. Coming a little bit into the anatomy of the tear film and the meibomian glands. First, the tear film, it has three layers. The outermost layer is called the lipid or the oily layer. The middle layer is called the aqueous layer or the watery layer. The innermost layer is called the mucin layer, which is adhered onto the cornea and the conjunctival surface. And the meibomian glands are almost 25 to 30 in number. They are glands which are placed vertically and parallel to each other, both in the upper lid as well as the lower lid, and their orifices open onto the lid margins. The outer lipid layer or the oily layer has a substance called nibim, which is secreted from the meibomian glands. It's a constituent of the lipid layer. The outer lipid layer, the main function of it is to retard evaporation. If there's a change or there's an altered secretion of the meibom, it alters the outer lipid layer and there is excessive evaporation. This is one of the reasons for dry eyes. The main way we treat it is after we do a meibomography. If we see a large number of gland dropouts or there's any blocked ducts, after evaluation of a meibomography, if we notice any kind of meibomian gland dysfunction, it can be treated with IRPL technology. IRPL stands for Intense Regulated Pulse Light Therapy. A little insight into the IRPL technology, a Xenon Arc lamp which produces a new polychromatic light which is pulsed and it is calibrated, and homogeneous pulse light is given in a sequential manner. The patient is reclined, the patient is given a protective eyewear, a copious amount of water-based gel which does not cause any kind of allergy is applied to the inferior orbital margin, and the IRPL is given, or the pulse light is delivered in a sequential manner. A different positioning is done close from the nasal edge till the temporal edge. The procedure is pretty safe. It takes about 2 to 3 minutes and the patient is comfortable. And once entire procedure is done, the protective eyewear is taken off and the patient can walk out. This IRPL or the pulse light is majorly given to stimulate the meibomian glands or the meibom cells to secrete a meibom. It's done usually on day 0, followed by day 15, followed by day 45. Optional if required on day 75. Usually the patient feels symptomatically better by the second sitting itself.